In this session, we are going to talk about the protein data bank. Protein data bank is the largest repository of biological 3D structures. The biological 3D structures are determined using experimental techniques like X-ray crystallography, nuclear magnetic resonance, and cryo-electron microscopy. Up to this date, there are millions of three-dimensional structures which are submitted to the protein data bank. This data bank is also known as PDB. In this data bank, most of the biological structures are protein. At this point, it will be worth to mention that the understanding of biological 3D structures is very important to understand their function. Therefore, this database is very, very important. Let's try to explore this database. Let's assume for a moment that you are interested in a one protein structure. A name of that protein is a serine protease. So we will write down the name of the serine protease in the search bar and we will click on this button. When we will click on this search button, then the search will begin, and after the few moments, all of the structures which will be related to your query, they will come here in front of you. In the last session, we have explained that what is a query. The query is something which you want to search in a database, and all of these results are related to our query. Now here on the left side, you could have a breakdown of the results. For example, here on this side, I'm going to have an idea that how many structures which are related to my query belongs to human, how many structures related to my query belongs to the muscular, and how many structures related to my query belongs to the E. coli and synthetic construct, and so on and on and on. So this is a breakdown with reference to the organism, organism in the protein data bank. So let's assume for a moment that I am interested in a one protein structure, and let's assume this is this protein structure in I'm interested. So get a more idea about my protein structure, I will click on this one, and when I will click on this one, I will directly land to the next page, which will be specific to my protein structure. And here you can actually see that specific page which is dedicated to my protein structure. Now here in this page, the first four letter code which you can see it here, this is known as the PDB ID. This four letter code is a combination of alpha and numerics, and this is a unique identifier which is assigned to the protein structure when that protein structure is submitted to the protein data bank. Now in the second line, I'm actually going to have an idea about the name of my protein, and the name of protein is pro-region of alpha lytic protease. The third line is letting me know about the unique identifier assigned to the manuscript in which that structure is published. This is also known as the DOI number. And then on the fourth line, we are going to have an idea about the classification of my protein. Right now, I'm going to have an idea this is a pro-region protein. But here you can find out the different words, like in case of the oxidoreductase enzyme, you are going to find out here the oxidoreductase class. In case of the transferase enzyme, you are going to find out here a transferase class, and etc. and etc. Then on the next line, you are going to have an idea of the organism from where your protein actually belongs. And on the next line, you are going to have an idea about the expression system, the system which is normally used to overexpress your protein for the crystallization purposes. Now, we are not going into the details of this expression system, that this is beyond the course scope of this course right now. At the bottom, you can actually see the deposit date and the release date of your protein structure. Now, this very structure is deposited to the protein data bank in 1998, and this was released in 1999. Now, question comes here that why there is a difference between deposit date and the release date. So, and the deposit date means that that is actually a date when the author submitted that protein structures to the authorities of protein data bank, and then the authorities of the protein data bank evaluated their structure, and if they found that structure correct, if they didn't find any discrepancies, then they will release that structure in 1999. And afterward, you can have an idea about the name of the authors who contributed in the determination of this structure. Further down at the bottom, you can actually see the experimental details. Now, obviously, we are not going to cover all of those experimental details here in this session. But there are some points which are very much important, which worth to note. The first thing, that the method which is used to determine this three-dimensional structure, and the method is X-ray diffraction analysis. In the beginning of this session, we discussed it that there are the three different methods which can be normally used to determine the three-dimensional structure of biological molecules: X-ray crystallography, and the second one is nuclear magnetic resonance, and third one is cryo-electron microscopy. So for this protein, the X-ray diffraction technique or X-ray crystallography is used to determine the three-dimensional structure. On the next line, you could have an idea about the resolution, and the resolution of this protein structure is 3 angstrom. And what does it mean? It means that we can actually see up to the 3 angstrom in this protein structure. Let's assume that there is another structure having a resolution of 2 angstrom. So then in that structure, we can see up to the 2 angstrom into the protein structure. Now you can actually ask a question here, that which structure will be better? Is it a 3 angstrom structure is better, or is it a 2 angstrom structure is better? And the answer of this question is very simple. Obviously, the 2 angstrom structure is better as compared to the 3 angstrom, because the 2 angstrom resolution is much higher. We can go more deep into the protein structure as compared to the 3 angstrom. What is an R value free, an R value work, and R value observed? These are the typical experimental details, and we are not going to see these details in this session. Then you could have an idea about the literature which is associated with your protein structure. This is the title of the manuscript in which your structure is published. Then this is actually the name of the authors. Then the journal and the date and the volume and the pages, the PubMed ID, the DOI number, and the abstracts. All of these details you can find out here in this literature section. At the bottom, you could have a further idea about your protein structure. Now, if you look at here on the left side, so on the left side, you could have you can see the structure of your protein. You can see the structure of your protein. And at the bottom, you could have an idea about that structure. For example, I'm going to have an idea here that my protein is 53.51 kilodaltons. And it's weight. There's total atoms which are presented here, that this one, and the residues number and the protein chains which are presented here. I would have an idea about all of them. Now let's assume for a moment that you are interested to visualize your three-dimensional structure in a three-dimensional space. So there are the two ways through which you can visualize your protein structure in a three-dimensional space. The one is an online, another one is an offline. Now let's try to explore first the online version, and to view your structure in a three-dimensional space online, you need to click on this 3D view button. So when you will click on this 3D view button, then you will land to the next page, and on this next page, you can see the protein structure in a three-dimensional space. You can use the mouse and you can rotate your three-dimensional structure in a three-dimensional space. Now, I wouldn't recommend it to you there to visualize or to see your protein structure online, because there are the many different things, many different features and the things which will not available here in this online versions. So I will highly recommend it to you there to download that three-dimensional structure onto your local machine and then visualize it by yourself by using certain specific softwares like PyMOL, like Chimera, and etc. and etc. We will talk about the protein visualization in detail later on. So to download that protein structure into your machine, you simply need to click on this download files button. And then when this drop-down menu will be open, then simply click on this PDB format. And when you will click on this one, so then the protein structure will be downloaded to your machine. And then later on, you can open that protein structure into into the softwares which are installed in your systems. We will have an idea about them inshallah later on. Now, then there is going to be, the next tab is going to be the annotation, and this annotation tab holds a good amount of information for you. In this annotation tab, you could have an idea about the fold of the protein, the family of the proteins, the domains which are present in your protein. But please let me first tell you that there are the two different type of the classification systems to classify the protein. The one is known as the SCOP, very famously, and the second one is the CATH. The both classification systems are valid, and they are going to give a good insight about the protein. So according to the scope classification system, I'm going to have an idea that in my protein, there is an alpha-lytic protease pro-domain-like fold. And this is a good information for me. And I'm also going to have an idea about the family, superfamily, and the domain. The same is about the CATH. In the CATH, I'm also going to have an idea about the class of the protein structures, its topology, and some homology of that domains, the proteins with some other protein structures. On the next step, there is going to be some experimental technique, data about the experimental techniques. We are not going to talk about these experimental techniques in detail because this is out beyond the scope of this session. Then we have then on the sequence step, we could have an idea about the sequence features of my protein, like where is the alpha helix, which part of the sequence is going to make the beta sheets, and etc. and etc. So at the top, you can actually see it here. This is a sequence. This is a sequence of my protein. It's approximately 166 total amino acid residues which are presented here. And then these red columns are letting me know that in this region, these sequences are making the alpha helix, and these yellow blocks are letting me know that these regions are making the beta sheets. So I could have an idea about the sequence features here on this tab. And finally, there's a genome tab which will let me know about the genome alignment. And most of the time, there isn't information available for my protein with the genome. So you can see it here that no genome alignment is right now available for my protein. So this is actually the PDB. This is a protein data bank, and this protein data bank holds a good amount of information about your protein. So in the last, I will highly recommend it to you to download the protein data bank to protein structure in the PDB into your machine, and then analyze it by yourself on your system. I hope so that this session will be informative for you. See you next time. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.